So DeepSeek just released its reasoning R1 model, and we're going to check out its coding capabilities in this video. And if you just check out their post, it's a fully open source reasoning model, and they claim that the performance is on par with OpenAI's O1 model. And here you can see that it is either outperforming or on par with O1. So this whole day I have been testing this model for coding, and it has really, really impressed me. Actually, I was not very happy with the V3 model, but R1 is quite amazing. And you will see that in this video. I'm quite sure whatever we throw at it, it's going to do well with that. And this is going to be an exciting video. Let's check it out. So I'm here in DeepSeek.com, and we have to click on this button. You can see here, DeepSeek R1 is now live and open source, rivaling OpenAI's model O1. Okay, so let's click on start now here. And it will be redirected to chat.deepseek.com. And in this chat interface, you can see that there is this button, Deep Think. If you just hover over it, you can see use DeepSeek R1 to solve reasoning problems. Okay, so let's click on that button. Now DeepSeek R1 is actually active. So we are going to build a tool website. The tool that we are going to build is an image to text converter. Let's give it this prompt. Use HTML, build me an image to text tool website. Keep the design modern. I do not want any card-like design. Keep the UI design flat. Make sure it has a header and a footer. Okay, so the design is mostly my preference. So let's see what it comes up with. So we can just straight away see the thinking. You can see here thinking. So DeepSeek is thinking here, and you can actually see all of it, all of its thought process here, which is actually quite detailed. And compared to O1, there is a lot more. Thought for 11 seconds, and it has started coding here. So it is coding in HTML, which is great. Okay, so let's see what it comes up with. Okay, we can click on this button, run HTML to see. Okay, so there is a header and there's a footer, which is nice. So there is click image to text, drag and drop, click to upload. Great, fantastic. And extract text. Let's see if it works. Let's click on that. Let's actually get this image in. Uploaded the image, extract text. Okay, so there is an error. So we're going to copy that. That's okay. We are going to say, okay, let's see. Just going to paste that in, and so it's thinking again. This is actually quite exciting to actually read what it is thinking. Okay, the user wants to implement OCR functionality using tesseract.js in their existing image to text converter website. I didn't say any of these things, but it understood what needs to be done. So that's really exciting. And I really don't know what any of those things mean, because I cannot code. And okay, so this time around, it has given some of those things. Okay, I'll do one thing. Because it has not given the full code, I'm just going to say, give me full code. Okay. Okay, so it's completed the code. Let's click on run HTML, click upload image, no file selected. Okay, so we'll have to say that. So I'm just going to give this prompt. The image upload functionality is missing. Give the full unabbreviated code. Do not skip anything important. Let's see. So it is always a back and forth between the AI and us giving it the right kind of prompt to get whatever we want. Let's see. Okay, the code is complete. Let's see. Okay, hopefully it works this time. Open image. The image is added. Great. Extract text. Recognizing text. Wow. It did it. All right. Okay. Did it get it right? Yes, it did. Fantastic. Amazing. So let's do one thing. This is actually very, very impressive. Very impressive. Let's copy the code. Let's go to codeviewit.com, and I'm just going to paste this here and preview it, and I'll just go to full screen. Okay. What are we missing here? So I did mention in the start that I don't want a card-like structure. I just wanted it to be flat. It did not keep that in mind. Go back to DeepSeek. So the functionality is working properly. So let's give this prompt. I want the website design to be more modern and stylish. You have used a card-like design for the tool interface. I don't want any background for this tool itself. Make the header and footer slick. So let's see what it comes back with. Sometimes it skips certain part of the code or gives a certain kind of abbreviation saying existing code or something like that. That everyone does. Oh yeah, See here. So here it has done the whole JavaScript functionality remains the same. So let's see. Keep the same JavaScript functionality from various previous version. Include all the JavaScript code from the previous implementation here. So this is actually an easy fix. So let's do one thing. Let's actually copy the entire code. We'll just remove this portion of the code from... Okay, let's go to code view it. I will go to code. And we need the script portion as it is. So let's do one thing. Let's select everything from here all the way up. I'm going to paste it there. And I will just remove this portion. Okay, so much. I'm just going to remove that because let me explain it. So here, this is the portion where we have the script. So we have the script here. So this is the same thing. So this portion is, we already have it. And this is the end. So we're just going to select it from here and delete all of that. Okay, that's it. So let's preview it. See, straight away, so much better. Look at that. This is very, very impressive. So actually the problem that I had with V3 was that it was not taking those simple prompts and not really doing much with regards to design, okay? So no matter how much we say give a slick design or a modern design or any of those things, it just wouldn't do it. It was just a little bit older in terms of design. So look at this. This looks really nice, clean. There's a slight animation. Look at this. So this is actually great. And we did not change anything in the JavaScript, so this should work as it is. So let's check if it does. If it doesn't, it should be a simple fix, I think. Let's import this image. It's imported. Great. Let's click on extract text. Oh, nothing's happening. That's sort of weird. But let's see. Let's come back into DeepSeek and actually give this prompt. After the design change, if I click on the extract text button, the image to text is not happening, even though I have maintained the JavaScript portion as it is. So let's see. Okay, so let's check out the new code. So I'm just going to copy these. So there is no change in the CSS. We have some changes here, I think. So let's do one thing. Let's copy them. So let's copy the script portion first. I'm just going to copy that and see if there is any change. This, let's paste it here. There's no change, so that's fine. So the CSS remains the same. Let's copy the body portion from there to the footer. I'll just copy that, come down. Let's find the HTML section here. Okay, I'm going to click and drag from the footer to the body. I'm going to paste it there and it's fine. Okay, come back here. And once again, I will just copy the script from here. Okay, just going to copy that because it seems like it's given the entire script here. So let's click and drag all the way up to the top here and I'll paste it there. So the script or the JavaScript has been pasted here. Hopefully this works. So let's click on preview and I'll just go to full screen itself. Click on the image. Let's upload it. The image is uploaded, which is great. Fantastic. Let's extract. Yes, it is recognizing. Oh, nice. So now we have the text. The image has been converted to text, which is fantastic. And look at the design. It looks beautiful. I think this is a great pass from my side for DeepSeek R1. I had actually tested it before. And trust me, every time I tried something, it did well. I remember when I started coding using Claude 3.5 Sonnet, there was that excitement, initial stages. And I got the same kind of excitement with this new model from DeepSeek. And that is exciting. And this is absolutely free. This is free. And I'm really not talking about anything which is slightly more complicated, maybe getting it into Cursor or any of the IDEs or anything like that. I'm literally talking about the chat interface and coding from the chat interface. This has done an amazing job. And I will be making more videos on DeepSeek R1 because this is very, very exciting for me. And I will do one thing. I'll make another video comparing 3.5 Sonnet and R1. And maybe we will actually give it a chance. The reason I rave about 3.5 Sonnet so much is because I have built multiple applications which are quite complicated, right? And it was able to help me build those things. And so I love 3.5 Sonnet. But this seems like something that also does a great job. And it's free. It's absolutely free. And that is its USP. And I'm going to give it some really hard tasks. And I hope that it does the job. And we can only know how good the model is when the code becomes really large, and how we can take one code, like a code that we get from one chat, take it to another chat, and then continue adding features to it, okay? So that is the real test, and we'll do all of that. We'll do that in multiple videos. And so stay tuned. And if you like to see more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, share it with your friends. And I will be back with a new video very, very soon. I'll see you in the next one.